Hi, I'm Christina Fuges with MoldMaking Technology Magazine, and I am at AmeriMold. Today with me is Jamie Sciturro of Autodesk. Hi, Jamie.
Hi, Christina. How are you?
Very well. I have a couple questions for you today.
Sure.
So can you define for me connected design and manufacturing?
Very simply put, it's when you have a fully integrated ecosystem within the product design process, rather than having, if you will, silos between teams.
Can you break that down between what that means to the OEM, to the molder, and to a mold builder, or is it all the same?
It is not the same. What it means is that the supply base and all the key stakeholders involved have a clear understanding of the product. In the end result, the customer benefits from this. And from a supply base, they can plan accordingly. And obviously for the OEMs, it means a better product that they can launch earlier and sell.
Can you define how connected design and manufacturing is disrupting traditional manufacturing?
It's disrupting it with tools that can be implemented in a fully digitized process. For instance, we talked about this morning, taking mold flow and applying texture to a mold flow. So you're bridging two worlds, essentially. You're taking the creative aspect along with the manufacturing aspect. And what this does is you're essentially creating a virtual digital part approval process, where before typically you're looking at physical parts to buy off. What this means in the end to a supplier is you're going to get paid earlier, which is very important. What it means to the automotive supply base is that you have a saleable vehicle that you can launch much earlier. So this typically can take 4 to 5 months to master something. And it also eliminates the need for prototype tooling. So huge advantage for everybody involved.
Time saver, right?
Yes.
Can you give an example of how a mold builder can design, make, and use in a different way?
I feel a huge tool to use is collaborative tools. As we see here in our booth, virtual tools. What that enables people to do, I mean, everybody's schedules are so tight and spread out. Even with an OEM, I reference, people can be miles away. So you need to have the right people to make the right decision at the right time. Using VR, doing collaborative reviews, you can make decisions on key decisions that need to be made, whether you're changing a part, the tooling, a parting line placement, without having everybody drive to one location.
So what advancements do you see coming down the pike in the future of making things?
I see more algorithmic design being adopted, generative design, leveraging the cloud, not just with part design, but also with tooling, the co-creation, those two worlds merging together into one ecosystem.
Thank you, Jamie.
Thank you, Christina.
For more information, visit moldmakingtechnology.com.